fairly well in the first half. Obviously have to pay it off, but I don't think he went in there and ripped them because their confidence was probably a little bit shaky. I think he spent the half trying to prop them up a little bit.
So Oklahoma, who deferred in the first half, will receive to start the second half. Bill Snyder's team very well prepared in the first two quarters. Anthony Cantelli will send it away. Roy Finch, Winnie Clay, the return men from OU. And this one kicked out of the end zone. Now let's go downstairs to Julie Alexandria.
Hey guys, I caught up with Coach Snyder going into the half, and he said, you know, we're fortunate to be ahead. We're not moving the ball really well, and we've given up a lot of yards of defense, but we're in the ball game. And then I caught up with Coach Stoops, and he said, very simply, we just got to take care of the ball. Guys?
And thank you very much, Julie. So Oklahoma starting from the 25. Justin Brown, Kenny Stills, your receivers at the top of your screen. Stills in the slot. And they hand it off, Whaley. And Whaley crosses the 30, picks up 8 on the play. Adam Davis with the tackle. Picks up the first down and more. Nigel Malone hauls him down, but it's an 11-yard pickup for Dominique Whaley.
A good block by the left tackle, Lane Johnson, getting out at the point of attack on the line of scrimmage, creating the crease.
Jones steps into this throw and knocked down at the last moment by Ty Zimmerman. Zimmerman stretching out and redirecting the football.
And he looked like an all-star baseball center fielder on this play. Read the ball, broke into the passing lane, and extended full out like it would be a layout catch in major leagues. This one he lays out and knocks the ball away. Zimmerman active all evening long.
Had the big fumble recovery with Oklahoma threatening on the 1-yard line. Lake Bell put it on the turf, 2nd and 10. Whaley. Maybe get 2 yards. Arthur Brown, the linebacker. Another tackle. So 3rd down and long. Sooners need 8 yards at the 45.
And all night, 3rd and long on defense has been the down for Kansas State to make plays. Oklahoma needs to tilt that balance back in their favor. 2 of 6 on 3rd down in the first half.
And how big would this be if Kansas State could hold them off on their opening drive? 3rd and 8 at the 45. Landry Jones over the middle, incomplete. And now you hear the boos. Oklahoma starts the second half, and they'll have to punt it away. Great defense by the Wildcats.
And look at Jared Milo, 23, playing deep, everything in front of him, able to break on the ball with help inside from Randall Evans, number 15. Why is Kansas State having success on 3rd down? They are winning 1st and 2nd down and forcing Oklahoma into long distance situations.
Ball start, offense, number 42, 5-yard penalty, 4th down.
They'll back it up 5 yards for Tressway, who will stand at the 26. Jermaine Thompson, the return man. Returned to punt 89 yards for a touchdown against Missouri State. Won't get an opportunity here, and it's downed at the 30. A 30-yard punt. K-State on the field offensively for the first time to start the second half, and they're up 10-6. Ranked team in the nation. Right now, they have the football at the 30, taking on sixth-ranked Oklahoma, the beginning of conference play for these two teams in the Big 12. Colin Klein, very efficient in the first two quarters. Harper in motion. Klein hands off. Hubert, and Hubert tackled before he gets back to the line of scrimmage. Javon Harris gets to him first. Tom Wharton also in on the play. As we take a look at the offensive leaders for the Wildcats. Klein, 6 of 10, 42 yards passing, 55 yards rushing. Hubert closing in on 100.
And rarely tackled on first contact with Hubert in the first half.
No gain on the last play, second down. And 10 yards to go. Here's the pitch, Hubert. Beautiful defense, Tony Jefferson right there. Only a 2 yard gain, brings up third down and 8.
Now, Hubert's tackled on the first contact that time. What a play by Jefferson. He and Javon Harris, the other safety, were within 10 yards of the line of scrimmage when the ball was snapped. Never retreated and came forward on the play. And that's how Jefferson was able to get there so quickly.
Third down and 8 at the 32. They need to go to the 40 for first down. Empty backfield for Klein. Colin Klein underneath, caught by Lockett, and Lockett close to the first down. It'll depend on the spot.
That should be short. That should be short. It was a good tackle in the open field by Gabe Lynn. That should be a fourth down.
Well, no. Judging by close. Our unofficial line.
Looks good, doesn't it?
It does.
I thought it was a good tackle. I thought he was short. That was my initial thought, was the tackle was made and he was down.
They needed to get to the 40-yard line. Whoa. Good eyes, partner.
Man, I didn't know they were that good. Field, but look at Lockett stretch out, but he doesn't stretch enough. Look where he goes down. If he reaches the ball, he's got the first down. But see, as he goes down, he never reaches.
Colin Klein, and the Wildcats are going to go for it. Fourth down and in. Dangerous play here.
And the play usually is quarterback sneak if they decide to actually go for it, if they don't try to draw them off with a long count.
Gets the first down.
The first effort, you nailed it. They had him. See right there? He's not getting there. Look at Ward over the top. But then Optimus Klein comes out. And gains the yard. See, right there they've got it, but look at the feet keep churning. He moves.
41 now for Kansas State. A handoff. And Hubert just stumbling forward. David King with the tackle, but Hubert was such a prolific running back in high school. He's from Waco High, and he broke the Waco City Prep single season rushing record. Over 2,500 yards, which was held by a guy that was a pretty good football player in the NFL.
Some guy named LaDainian Tomlinson?
Yes.
And he was not recruited by his home size.
Second and 5 at the 46. And Colin Klein tackled up high. Wow. Corey Nelson. Colony.
That was a 7-on-7 right there. Watch into the gap. Goes inside the attempted block by Tavon Rooks. And lassos him down. Not an illegal play. A strong, aggressive play by Nelson.
So on third down and 4, Colin Klein lines up in the shotgun. at the 47-yard line. He needs to go to the Oklahoma 49. And a timeout called by OU. 9:34 to play in the third quarter. Mike Stoops. Welcome back, 10-6. Kansas State faced with the third down and four at the 47.
They've spread them out a lot on third down. And in this game, I believe Oklahoma's had to use three timeouts on defense already tonight.
Clyde wants to run it. Bottled up. Clyde leans forward. And let's see where they spot the football. Remember, Kansas State went for it on fourth and inches on this drive at the 39.
They went for it then. You would think he'd go ahead and do it now with a little bit better field position, because he doesn't think it's a gamble with Klein. He's shocked if Klein can't pick up that distance, quarterback sneaking it or quarterback run game. Klein looks like he's saying about timeout so they can go talk about it.
8:54 to play, third quarter. 10-6, Kansas State. Welcome back. 8:54 to go in the third. 10-6. Kansas State going for it on fourth down and one. Charles, this seems like a huge moment in this football game.
To me, it feels like both sides are thinking this game could almost be decided on this drive. We've had timeouts on back-to-back plays, one by Oklahoma on defense, one by Kansas State. The second fourth down try for Kansas State on this drive.
Here's Klein under center now. Colin Klein. And now they'll kick it.
Well, they went from showing that they would go for it to the we'll try and draw you off sides and use your momentum against you. Good discipline by Oklahoma not to jump. And now Bill Snyder will run the punt team out there and one of his favorite weapons, and that's been his punter, Ryan Dorr.
Ryan Dorr has been terrific, consistently pinning Oklahoma inside their own 20-yard line. And he gets off a beauty here, and he'll do it again. Fair caught at the 12. A 43-yard punt for Ryan Dorr. Now tomorrow, Fox
game, and Kenny Stills is the go-to guy, but their connection has waned a little bit as this game has moved on.
Jones and the Oklahoma offense will have to attack the long field with the football at the 12. And they put it on the deck again. Kansas State has it. Adam Davis with the fumble recovery. The third fumble for OU.
What Oklahoma's going to say is that that should be a forward pass and an incomplete pass. Watch Landry Jones. He's going to claim that he pitched it forward. That ball never really was received by him in order to pitch it forward. In my estimation, to me, that's a fumble. See, he's trying to say that he just pitched it forward. It should be an incomplete pass. I don't know if he possessed it enough to call it that.
And if this holds up, Kansas State with the football at the 10, their offense is back on the field. Three fumbles by Oklahoma.
See, that's super slow-mo. You could make a case that he caught it and tried to pitch it forward. Naked eye, that sure looked like a fumble here.
Ruling on the field is a fumble. Previous play is under further review.
Now, slow motion really skews this, so you have to look at it at regular speed, which they're going to look at too. Did he actually maintain possession of that ball or get possession of the ball, which then would make him a runner, which then makes it a fumble? Now, Mike, this is what they ruled that he did not. Mike, and again, I think this is going to be interesting because to me, he doesn't have that ball to actually, just like completing the process of a catch, to me, he doesn't maintain that long enough. Although, you look at that slow motion there, he pushes the ball forward. But it's really a tight, tight play.
But Mike, are they looking at it in slow motion or are they looking at it in regular speed? That's
they're
the key
gonna
to
look
me.
At it. They're going to look at it at both ways, but just like in the NFL, you're told to look at it at regular speed. So just the way that the officials looked at it on the field. When you get to the sideline and you're trying to determine is a foot down on the side, and then you slow it up and actually stop it. But here going in slow motion, they'll take a look at it, but they're going to focus on a live play like that. You know, even you kind of see his feeling when he just let go of the ball so quickly. You know, to me, I think the fact that they ruled fumble, I just, other than that slow motion, I don't know if you can overturn it.
Mike, I think what you said about second act comes into play here, because I think it looks like one act by Landry Jones. Ball hits his hands, ball comes forward. A case can be made that he was trying to push it forward, but I'm not sure they're going to overturn this one.
I think it's the old notion to me, you kind of have to look at things and say it has to be so clear in replay to overturn what the actual ruling on the field was. They use the same terminology, indisputable visual evidence. The decision that's going to have to be made by the replay assistant upstairs, and remember, he makes that decision, not the referee, is if there's enough to actually reverse it.
After
based on
review,
that.
The ruling is incomplete pass. It'll be second down.
Oklahoma catches a major break.
Game clock to 8:45. 8:45 on the game clock.
Mike, thanks a lot. Gus, they watched it. They determined it off the super slow-mo. Because in the super slow-mo, when we really slowed it down, you could see it hit his hands, and you could see him kind of push the ball forward. Watch. As it hits his hands, he's pushing it forward towards the running back. When you watched it at the naked eye at regular speed, that looks like it hits his hands, bounces off, and is a fumble. I'm with you. Oklahoma caught a major break and gives them an opportunity now to try and convert on second and long.
And let's see if that wakes up this Sooners football team, especially their offense. A number of mistakes made by OU's offense this evening, down at home 10-6. Landry Jones in the shotgun on second and 10. Jones under pressure, dumps it off. Damian Williams. And Damian Williams has a first down. Meshack Williams with the tackle.
And when things get tough, you're looking for players who will make plays. And Damian Williams did exactly that, finding a way to get first down yardage on that pass.
Williams running now. Damian Williams, transfer from Arizona Western, where he led the NCAA in rushing. 161 yards a game and a school record 31 touchdowns last season. Jones, far side. Brown, and he gets out of bounds. Alan Chapman there defensively for K-State.
You noted before they started, after they got the ball back, would this help them with their momentum? And thus far, that is true. And you wonder about Kansas State if they got comfortable on the bench thinking that they had the football.
Over the middle, and another nice catch by Sterling Shepard. Shepard has been terrific this evening. His fourth catch.
He stepped into the breach. Remember, Matuire was the highly recruited guy, but he got smacked early by Arthur Brown, and we haven't really heard from him since. Sterling Shepard has stepped into the breach for Oklahoma and picked up the pace.
Four catches, 72 yards for Shepard. First down at midfield. Jones, near side. Shepard again. He'll get to the 40 before being slung out of play. Nigel Malone, Jared Milo, defensively for the Wildcats.
They have hit, look at this, now at Oklahoma, after 20 seconds, 21 seconds between plays tonight. That's not how they approached the first two games. The open week helped them with the experience with these guys, the youngsters, and when they hit big plays, they go even faster.
Second and one. Play fake, Jones. Caught. Matuire. Out of bounds at the 12. Now the Sooners have their rhythm as they quickly get back to the line of scrimmage. But he stepped out of bounds.
Yeah, and see the hat on the ground from the official?
Here's the handoff. Damian Williams.
I thought when he stepped out, was forced out, and the hat hit the ground from the official, that you couldn't be the first guy to touch the ball when he came back in bounds. And that has gone past now, so Oklahoma continues their drive. On the positive note for Oklahoma's receivers, I'm seeing a real physicality on this drive after they catch the football and catch it and get upfield.
Second and five at the 9-yard line. Jones underneath. Kenny Stills. Is it a catch? Yes, it is.
And they'll get a flag on the play. I'm sure it's going to be interference on the back play on the backside of Stills. And let's clarify, Matuire, when he was forced out of bounds in the college game, Gus, you can get back in and be the first guy to catch it. Legal play.
Pass interference, defense, number 15. Kelly's declined. Result of play, first down.
Look at the throw. Stills going down, draped over the top.
Whoa. Looks like that ball hit the ground. But there is a pass interference penalty anyway. First down and goal at the 2.
And no belldozer here.
Andrew Jones staying in. Handing it off. Miller.
Bell comes into the game. But if you're Oklahoma, you know that's what they know you're coming with. If you're going to throw the ball in these situations, second down's always the key down. Do they do any type of a fake and let Bell, who is a natural quarterback, have a run pass option?
Second and goal at the 3. Can Oklahoma finally punch it into the end zone? Bell running. Bell! Touchdown OU! Minutes remaining in the third quarter. And Oklahoma finally gets 6. Michael Honeycutt in to attempt the extra point. Sooners up 13-10. Some big moments in this game, folks. Oklahoma catches a break on the review. It may have scared them, because they march it right down the field, and the belldozer, it's Pater. Oklahoma, after the controversial play, goes 11 plays, 88 yards, eating up 3:46. Landry Jones, 6 for 6 on the drive, 65 yards.
And don't forget the catch by Stills down deep that Oklahoma declined the penalty. It would have been a penalty. It would have been half the distance, but it still would not have been first and goal where it was. It would have been deeper in the field, but give Oklahoma credit. They caught breaks. They capitalized.
This is Tyler Lockett at the 30. Lockett with a very good return as he gets up to the 35. A 23-yard return. Let's go to Aaron Andrews for a game break.
Hey,
thank you very much, Aaron, and you feel bad for what's happened at Arkansas.
This whole thing, if that holds up, a season so full of promise implodes in the first 4 weeks of the 2012 campaign.
Here's the run. Matter of fact, the last time we saw Arkansas, it was against Kansas State in the Cotton Bowl, which was a very good day for the Razorbacks.
And if after that game, they could have made a case that they were the third best team in the country at the end of that one, because their losses last year to number one and number two at the time, one LSU, two Alabama, and those two finished 1-2. Oklahoma State would have had a major dispute with them, but Arkansas still could have made the claim.
Second down and 7 now at the 38. Klein, play fake, sets up deep in the pocket to the sideline. Oh, what a catch! Chris Harper, quality reception, a gain of 21 and a first down in front of Aaron Colvin.
There's nothing you can do here but say excellent catch, because Aaron Colvin's coverage was right on. Draped all over him, a hand in front, got a hand on the football, and give Chris Harper credit for making the play.
Second catch for Harper. First down and 10 at the 41. Kansas State inside Oklahoma territory. Klein steps back. Klein up the sideline, incomplete. And he had an open man from Nate Thompson. Had a step, but Klein unable to put it on him.
But you see the benefits of the heavy run by Kansas State, where now they get into excellent field position. Nice down and distance, first and 10. You have safeties that they're hoping will overreact to the run fake, and you've got a guy running free. He was open. Klein just couldn't put it on him.
Second down and 10 of the 41. Empty backfield for Colin Klein. This is usually where he likes to run to pick up 4 or 5. Klein delivers. Klein knocked down. Great play on defense by Oklahoma. Javon Harris knocks it down. Intended for Tremaine Thompson.
So take a look here. Klein goes back. Oklahoma retreats. They only end up having one guy rush the passer, everyone else dropping for the shallow cross. And Javon Harris, with good catch-up speed, knocks it away.
So that brings up a third down and 10 at the Oklahoma 41. Kansas State needs to go to the 31 for a first down. Four receivers at the bottom. Klein lets it go. Oh, incomplete. Wow. That one just simply dropped by Terrell Miller, a junior from New Orleans.
Terrell Miller had just 2 catches in the regular season in 2011. This would have made up for that in a big way. And it goes right through his mitts, unable to secure it. Not even contested till after the ball has gone past. The Oklahoma defense holds.
So Dorr comes in to punt. All 4 of his punts inside the 20-yard line, trying to get this one high in the air. This kid is wonderful. Maybe the best punter we've seen.
And works in tandem with a special teams unit that understands positioning. No one there to catch the punt. You go catch the punt and down it. You don't have to let it hit the ground if there's no one there to catch it.
Now this week, the Fox College Football Social Poll on Facebook asked fans who is the best quarterback in the Big 12. Here are the results of the poll. To cast your vote, log on to facebook.com/Fox Sports. And 57% of you said Geno Smith from West Virginia. West Virginia, first year in the conference.
And Geno Smith slings it like a traditional quarterback. Colin Klein almost shouldn't even be in a quarterback category. He's just a different animal entirely. We asked Mike Stoops what it's like to prepare for him. Who have you prepared for like that before? He said no one. Totally unique.
So Oklahoma starting deep in their own end as Dominique Whaley picks up 2.
Here's something for us to keep in mind. All the bumps and bruises along the way. Look at the scoreboard. Oklahoma's ahead. Did they catch some breaks on the last drive? They did. But did they make their own breaks once they got them? They certainly did that too and put it in the end zone. Now they have the lead and the football again.
Second down and 8. Landry Jones fires Justin Brown and a first down.
Is it just me or is Landry Jones getting a little bit more time to throw football now?
Certainly is.
And when he has the time and his feet are clean in the pocket and he can step into throws, that's when his accuracy rises.
First down from the 16. Brown on the blitz, they pick him up, and once again it's Justin Brown with the reception in front of Alan Chapman. So take a look at the total yards by half. Oklahoma 182 in the first, 128 in the second. Kansas State slowing down a bit. Second down and 4.
Don't be surprised at some point you see some stop and go action with an Oklahoma receiver as tightly contested as the corners are playing the receivers right now.
Play fake, Jones off his back foot, picked off. Ty Zimmerman at the 42. Mistake after mistake after mistake. 3 turnovers for Oklahoma. 2 fumbles, now a Landry Jones interception. And Kansas State is in business.
And frankly, this throw kind of defies belief that that's a fourth-year guy at the quarterback position making that throw. He worked so hard in the offseason working on mechanics and footwork, and it got away from him on that play. If he didn't feel right on it, take the sack, move on.
Ty Zimmerman, a fumble recovery, now an interception. Kansas State starts at the 38. They hand it off straight ahead, and it's Hubert fighting for extra yards. But in on the play, David King. Mentioned his name a number of times this evening.
He's their bell cow up front. He's their best defensive lineman. He's had to play tackle the first 2 games with guys not there. They got Casey Walker back, who missed the first 2 games for personal reasons. Able to kick David King out to his natural defensive end position. He'll come inside at tackle and pass rush in key situations.
Second down and 9 at the 37. Klein, Hubert, as he jitterbugs for maybe 3 yards. And that'll bring up third down and 6.
In the first half, it was Kansas State's defense picking up their offense and helping them out. This is a situation now that OU is looking for their defense to pick up their offense.
Third down at 6. At the 34, 4 receivers at the bottom. Klein drills it in. And a first down. Tyler Lockett cradles the football. And a first down for Kansas State. And folks, that takes us to the end of the third quarter. We head into the fourth. Oklahoma at home, up by only 3. Welcome back. Start of the fourth quarter, 3-point ball game. The number 6 team in the nation holding on. Kansas State has scored 10 points off turnovers. Landry Jones throwing his first interception of the night. And Kansas State trying to capitalize off another turnover right here. First down and 10 at the Oklahoma 27.
I like the matchup up top if he wants to throw Harper against Jefferson, the safety.
Klein bounces it outside with running room. And he tiptoes out of bounds after about a 7.5, 8-yard gain. And let's go to Aaron Andrews for a game break.
To 27.
All right, thank you, Aaron. Second and 2 at the 19. For Colin Klein, John Hubert in the backfield. He'll run it straight ahead and pick up the first down. And Moe spins down. Hubert inside the 10-yard line. Tony Jefferson with the saving tackle. And look at the vision of Hubert. Once he sees the crack, look at that. And now he gets through it. There's McFarland, 97, trying to hold him. He can't. Spins out of it. Jefferson has to sling him to the ground.
The Wildcats were involved in 9 games, decided by 7 points or fewer last season, and won 8 of them. First down and goal at the 8. Hubert. And Hubert with the low center of gravity. Gets close to the 5, Tom Wharton.
Do you remember the game Battleship?
Yes. What
you said?
Yes.
E6.
Yes.
Right?
Right.
And then finally score, a direct hit.
Right.
There is none of that on John Hubert. It's been rare that it's been a direct shot on him. He finds a way to make you only get a piece of him, and he finds a way to get forward on 98% of his runs.
Second down and goal. Ball at the 5. Colin Klein wants to run it. Outside! Klein! Touchdown! K-State! What patience!
I loved how you described that, the patience. Why? He allowed his blocking to form, and it starts here. Watch Braden Wilson, his fullback. He's coming here to block, but watch how Klein waits for this play to develop. He doesn't go too fast, otherwise he loses the block. He waits, now he gets the block from Braden Wilson, then he gets a second one from Hubert, Tyler Lockett gets in the way, and Colin Klein gets into the end zone.
So Anthony Cantelli comes in to tip the extra point. Up and good. Colin Klein last year, tied an FBS record for quarterbacks with 27 rushing touchdowns. He picks up a big one here. We've got a game for you tonight, folks. Kansas State 17, Oklahoma 13. Colin Klein with the big touchdown run for the Wildcats.
And something you mentioned in the break rings so true. It looks simple, what Kansas State's doing on offense. But what they're trying to do is just beat you with numbers. That's why Colin Klein was waiting for Braden Wilson to cross over. That gave them the advantage with the extra blocker. Bob Stoops talked about that to Julie Alexandria at the top of the show. Extra blockers in the quarterback run game, hard to solve, and that gave them an advantage again.
This is Brennan Clay at the 20. And Clay wrapped up at the 35-yard line. A 33-yard return, and that brings us to tonight's 4 game summary.
Take a look at Colin Klein getting what we expected out of him in the second half, not the same as last year in Manhattan. The 3 takeaways leading to 17 points for Kansas State. Oklahoma, the 14-0 record at home versus ranked opponents under head coach Bob Stoops, is getting a test this evening.
So much history between these two generals roaming the sidelines. Bill Snyder, Coach Bob Stoops, when he was a safety at Iowa, gave him his first head coaching job at Kansas State as a DB's coach. He was there for 8 years on the run. Williams down the sideline, flag on the play. Williams, touchdown, but there's a flag all the way back at the 40, and there's an official pointing. Williams may have stepped out of bounds.
Holding, up, number 19, 10-yard penalty, repeat first down.
That's Justin Brown.
Jay Norvell's the wide receivers coach and co-offensive coordinator. And he wants to spend a lot of time, and he always does, teaching his receivers and talking about being physical in the run game. But he gets a little cloth and pads of Alan Chapman, number 3. And that's where the step out occurred. The officials on the spot for both calls.
So first down and 16 at the 29. The 6th ranked team in the country, Oklahoma, trailing at home to Kansas State. Landry Jones fumbled the snap. Jones, and he dumps it out of bounds.
And that was good presence because he saved the yardage that would have been lost by getting rid of the football. Gabe Eichert is the center. Tough snap there.
for Landry Jones. Remember, Ben Haybert was supposed to be the starting center this year, had to retire due to injuries. Gabe Eichert played center about half the season last year and moved over, and usually it's a seamless deal. That was a tough snap.
Second down and 16 at the 29. Now Brennan Clay lining up behind Landry Jones in the pistol. Jones. Ball caught. Nice throw. And this will be Brandon Green with the reception. The tight end picking up 9 on second and 16. Now 3rd and 7 at the 38. Jones bouncing. Jones underneath. And Landry Jones and the Oklahoma offense will punt it away.
And the pressure got him off of his mark. Because watch the pressure on Landry Jones in the pocket. Number 44, Ryan Mueller. Number 2, Justin Tuggle. See, they made him move. And when he moved and got out there, wasn't able to get reset and get anything on the football.
Third punt for Tressway. Tyler Lockett. Back deep. Way gets it away. Now Lockett coming up. Did he touch it?
I've not seen a definitive call about possession, but it appears that he's going to say he didn't touch it and the ball will go to Kansas State.
First touching, Oklahoma. Oklahoma ball.
Wow!
Wow! I did not see that on the definitive call.
Whoa!
They're huddling again, Gus. I'm not sure that's going to stand. Because we're getting another huddle from the officials on the field as we speak. Let's take a look.
You think he'll touch him by the kicking team? First down.
He touched it.
Yeah.
See? Did he touch it?
But see, the initial touch was Oklahoma. So that's what he was trying to say. So that's why it will stay with Kansas State. No possession.
They corrected the call. 17-13 K-State. .11:59 remaining in the fourth quarter. 17-13, Kansas State gets the football back at their own 23.
There's Tyler Lockett feeling fortunate because either run up and catch the ball on the punt or get out of the way. And that one almost became a disaster for Kansas State.
Klein on the run. Ball caught. Tannehill is tight end. And Tannehill with some nice running after the catch as he picks up 20 yards to Montre Hurst. Stops him.
They don't throw to the tight ends very often, but when they do, they get big yardage. Tannehill, that's his 3rd catch of the year. His previous 2, he's averaging 25 yards a catch. They get him into open field after they fool you in the run game.
First down at the 44. Here's a jet sweep. Lockett. And he stopped by Javon Harris. Now let's go to Aaron Andrews in Los Angeles for a game break.
Let's show October.
Well, thank you very much, Aaron. 2nd and 7 at the 47. Kansas State leading at 17-13. Colin Klein follows his blocks, hops forward, a flag on the play.
Holding, offense, number 73. 10-yard penalty, 2nd down.
Tavon Rooks, the right tackle.
Yeah, you see him, he's got that front face, it's almost a cross face in wrestling, except he got it in the chest to hold him up.
As he brought down Jamarcus McFarland. So that'll make it 2nd and 17 at the 37. Penalties. Klein giving it up to Tremaine Thompson. And Thompson picks up about five. As we approach the 10-minute mark of the fourth quarter. Big third down coming up for Kansas State.
And the hard part for Bob Stoops and his brother Mike is that just because it's third and long, it doesn't mean that you can play pass only with Colin Klein. They like to spread you out, keep the box count small in here, and possibly run it inside if he doesn't have a pass play available.
Third down and 12 of the 42. They need to go to the Oklahoma 46 for a first down. And Klein calls a timeout. One timeout remaining for K-State. Back after this. Another big moment in this football game. Third down and 12 for Colin Klein in Kansas State. Sooners want the ball back, trailing 17-13. Klein in the shotgun. Three receivers at the bottom of your screen. There's Wart. He may be the spy on Klein. If he tries to get out and run, Klein.
Sideline. He's got his receiver. Thompson. First down, K-State. What a play. Tremaine Thompson wide open, and Colin Klein put it on the money. 26 yards.
How does he do this all the time? Because what they did was everything went this way and moved him out here. Look at how their secondary responded. They got everything going to the middle and then swung Thompson from the inside position to the outside. And Colin Klein, say what you want about his motion on big plays. He looks like Johnny Unitas at times.
First down and 10 of the OU 32. Hubert running. And Hubert dragged down at the 25-yard line by Ndule.
Another set of downs they got on the throw, and the clock continues to tick.
8:40 and counting. Second and three at the 25. Hubert again, looking for the first down, turned away. David King, Tony Jefferson. 8:12 to go though. Klein and the Wildcats very patient offensively, and there is some serious anxiety on the Oklahoma sideline.
And they picked up a first down. Because now what Oklahoma has to be thinking is, how do they create a turnover? They've been a turnover machine, taking the ball away under Bob Stoops. Has not happened so far, not has that happened much in this young season.
Klein throwing to his tight end once again, Tannehill. He stays inbounds and picks up a first down.
Pass is complete to Travis Tannehill.
And watch Tannehill as he turns it upfield. Now he feeds his pads to Javon Harris and makes him pay for coming through to make the tackle. Continues on for a little bit of extra yardage. And Bill Snyder, I'm wondering if he's thinking right here, touchdown exclusively, and not kick a field goal, give Landry Jones a chance to bring him down and go ahead.
First down and goal at the 9-8 play of the drive for Kansas State. Hubert!
Touchdown, Cats!
Kansas State, 7:27 away from upsetting the sixth-ranked team in the country on their home pitch.
And watch Hubert again, all right? 5'7", 190 or so, but watch. He gets caught in the morass there. There's Harris, 30, Wart, 21. They don't get a direct shot. And McFarland unable to put him down either, and he squirts through for the touchdown.
Eight plays, covering 77 yards. K-State eats up 4 minutes and 32 seconds. Bill Snyder's team, relentless, persistent, physical, and focused. 24-13, Kansas State. Upset brewing in Norman, Kansas State leading Oklahoma 24-13 with 7:27 to go in the fourth quarter. Landry Jones has work to do. Colin Klein has been terrific. As you take a look at the scoring drive, 8 plays, 77 yards. Heating up 4:32.
How about Kansas State now for the game? 8.5 minutes more of time of possession than Oklahoma. And Kansas State beat North Texas last week. North Texas had the ball for 37 minutes. Not normal for Kansas State, but they found a way to win the game.
Roy Finch, Brennan Clay back deep. This one short, Millard. And Millard gets up to the 35. And that brings us to this evening's Reese's Perfect Play.
And it's the play that really set the tone for the evening. Third and long, deep in their own territory is Oklahoma. Kansas State's coverage is tight in the secondary. They get after Landry Jones. Justin Tuggle, a former quarterback himself, knocks it free, reminiscent of the play of his father, Jesse Tuggle, a 5-time Pro Bowler in the NFL. And Jarrell Childs falls on it in the end zone, the first touchdown of the evening for Kansas State.
First down to their own 35. Jones. Ball caught. McGuire.
There's plenty of time left in this game.
Oklahoma with 2 timeouts remaining. And they hand it off to Damian Williams.
We're at 7 minutes, and as prolific as Oklahoma can be and as quick strike as they can be on offense, plenty of time. They can score, and their defense can hold for them. But those are big ifs, the way Kansas State makes you earn every snap.
First down at the 47. Jones in trouble. Landry Jones, and he is sacked.
Not sure if the ball came free at the end. There seemed to be a little bit of a scramble at the end.
Landry Jones sacked for the second time tonight. A loss of 8.
Once he got hemmed in, Meshack Williams, and on the ground, Javonte Boyd making the play. Had to dive on it to secure the football.
Second down and 18. Jones in trouble again, but gets it away to his running back, Williams. Williams trying to get out of bounds. And he is wrestled down. Ryan Mueller.
I think we're in 4-down territory. They don't get it here. They're going to have to go for it on 4th down.
3rd down and 9, Jones, and he gets it. Throws a strike to guess who? Sterling Shepard. A 17-yard pickup. 1st down, OU.
That's as well thrown a ball as we've seen from Landry Jones in a while now. He stuck that right on Sterling Shepard, and that young freshman has grown up quickly. Number 3, Shepard.
1st down, Brennan Clay comes in. Standing next to Jones in the backfield. They give it to Clay. Turns it up, picks up a 1st down.
This is not what Tom Hayes, the defensive coordinator for Kansas State, has in mind. Oklahoma picking up big chunks of yardage on plays, not using much clock.
Jones going for everything. Out of bounds. McGuire, the intended receiver. And that stops the clock at 5:01.
I think that's a play that they'll go back over with a young receiver. and maybe some timing with Landry Jones. You have to have room to fade in the end zone. By the time his ball's released, Matuire's over at the sideline. No chance to make the play.
Second and 10. Jones draw play. Running Clay. And Clay gets to the 20.
Stills is the go-to here. He'll be at the bottom of your screen, to the right of your screen. But Shepard has made plays at the top. There's Stills. There are Fox player pointer. And Shepard in the slot at the top.
Third down and 6 at the 20. Here's Jones. And this would caught Justin Brown, and he'll get to the 10. The former Big Ten product. And we'd like to welcome those of you that watch Notre Dame defeat Michigan. We've got a great one here, folks. 4:21 to go in the fourth. Oklahoma, the 6th-ranked team in the nation, trailing Kansas State at home 24-13. Sooners have turned it over 3 times. Jones over the middle. Caught. The freshman dives. Touchdown, Sterling Shepard. Landry Jones will stay on the field. Oklahoma going for 2. Down 24-19.
Need the 2 to get within a field goal of Kansas State if they're able to get the ball back.
Jones in the shotgun with Brennan Clay. Here's Jones rolling out.
Timeout. Oklahoma.
Wow. Oklahoma.
30 seconds.
With only 1 timeout remaining now. Both teams with only 1 timeout.
Did you see that set, partner? Watch this, okay? Because look over here. Do you know who this is? That's your starting left tackle, Lane Johnson. They moved him out there. Remember, he came to Oklahoma as a junior college tight end and quarterback before growing into an offensive tackle position. And that was a play just to create confusion on the defense.
Forget next week. UT rolls into Stillwater to take on the Cowboys. The game developing now, 24-19, 4:09 to go. OU back on the field, going for 2. Kenny Stills in the slot at the bottom. Rennie Clay in the backfield. Jones. And it's deflected and knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Justin Tuggle once again making a play. So with 4:09 to go, Kansas State with a 24-19 lead. This time, Bob Stoops with only 1 timeout remaining. Does he have a decision to make?
He has a decision to make about onside kicking. I think when they had to take the timeout in the 2-point play and left him with only 1, it may have forced his hand where he may have to onside kick. And you know Kansas State's going to line up hands team.
So O'Hara. Into deep and out of the end zone. He drilled that one. Kansas State with it at the 25.
They're going to rely on their defense here.
And let's go downstairs to Julie Alexandria.
Hey guys, I just caught defensive coordinator Mike Stoops rallying his troops, saying, keep your head up, keep yourselves together. You gotta go back out there and you gotta play. Get yourself geared up and keep playing on.
And their playing on means they can't give up first downs. Just one timeout left. They can't allow Kansas State to put together any type of drive and bleed this clock out. They're counting on them to stuff them here and have a chance to get the football back.
First down and 10 to the 25 for Colin Klein. And Kansas State running the football. McFarland downing John Hubert. Each team with one timeout remaining. And Kansas State's three scoring drives, they've held the ball for 6:59, 2:54, and 4:32. Second down and 11. Klein wants to throw it. Clock stops. 3:23. Third down and 11.
That's a good play on defense by Oklahoma because they took away the primary target. He wanted to go to Tremaine Thompson after the fake into the secondary. And Oklahoma took that option away from him.
Third down and 11 at the 24. The Sooners, they feel the momentum swinging. They've got a chance to get the rock back right here. Klein over the middle. Klein, first down, K-State. What a play. Tremaine Thompson on third and 11 picks up 13.
And how about not just the throw, but the route? Because Tom Ward in the middle of the field, that receiver crossed his face, and he didn't chuck him or put his body on it. Allowed him to run right past him. Watch Ward in the middle and watch the route. Unable to get there, puts nothing on him. He gets past him. First down.
A fresh set of downs for the Wildcats. 2:56 away. Hubert. And Hubert chopped down Javon Harris after a 5-yard pickup. Don't forget, coming up next, Aaron and the guys with the AT&T postgame show, Joey Harrington and the Heisman Trophy winner, Eddie George.
If you're Kansas State, if you snap this ball anywhere outside of 5 seconds on the play clock, you're doing your team a disservice. Let it bleed down.
Second down and 5. Klein to Hubert. And Hubert will gain 2.5. And a timeout called. Oklahoma out of timeouts, trailing 24-19. Colin Klein, masterful performance this evening as the leading man for Kansas State. Wildcats now face with a third down and 3. Oklahoma out of timeouts.
I've got to keep the ball in the hands of number 7 quarterback run game here.
Do or die for the Sooner defense right here, right now. And now Kansas State will call a timeout. Most important statistic, the story of this game, turnovers.
And look at the points off of them for Kansas State. 17 off of the 3 takeaways. Oklahoma normally takes it away from their opponents. 0 on the evening. And the timeout situation also has now come into play.
Third down and three at the 43. Kansas State has converted three third downs in a row. Clyde hesitates. Clyde, first down, Wildcat.
And no one has any timeouts left, neither side. So Oklahoma can't stop them at all, with Colin Klein now picking up the first down of the game. Remember, no timeouts for Kansas State. Play clock at 10.
And they're just getting to the line of scrimmage. Looks like they'll take a knee and try to bleed this one out. And that's what he does.
It's the right play with no timeouts left for Oklahoma. The clock should run out for them.
How about this? The teacher, Bill Snyder, comes into Norman, Oklahoma, and school in session against his former pupil, Bob Stoops. Major upset in college football. Last week, USC falling to Stanford in Palo Alto on Fox Sports. This week, Kansas State coming into Norman. And they're 34 seconds away from upsetting the Oklahoma Sooners.
Should not have to take another snap. And now, Bob Stoops had been 7-1 against Bill Snyder.
Bob Stoops was 14-0 against ranked teams. At home, that streak comes to an end as the two gentlemen meet and hug. 24-19 the final. Kansas State, what a performance. Now let's take you to Aaron Andrews in our Fox studio for the AT&T Fox College Saturday postgame show.